So in our last video, we showed how we can deploy our Django application up into Microsoft Azure. There's one thing I kind of skimmed over towards the end and mentioned that the database, while we deployed with SQLite, that's okay just to get us started. It's really not a very scalable option. And actually, every time you deploy your application back into Azure, it's going to override that file. SQLite's really mostly used as a testing database. It can be used in production environments, but it's quite tricky to get right. A better option is actually to deploy a database server. And I mentioned that Postgres is a popular database server that is offered in Microsoft Azure. So in this next video, I'm going to show you how to change your application to use a full database server and how to deploy one of those in your Azure environment. So first things first, we're going to go to the Azure tab in VS Code. And down at the bottom, there should be a section called databases. Same as before, you will need to make sure you've signed into Azure first with your Azure account. And just as we created a new application here through the App Service component, we would create a new component here for databases through the databases pane. So if you click on Create Server here and then pick Postgres, we need to provide a unique name for our Postgres server, and this will also form what we connect to when we've deployed. So I'm going to use Ants Ruddy Cloud DB and then enter. And we need a username that we're going to connect to the database with. This will also form the administrator username. Typically, you'd have one user account for the admin and then one for the web application, just in case the web application goes a bit crazy or you accidentally put a security hole in. But for now, I'm just going to create one username. We'll keep it simple. And I'm going to call that Django. So that the username will be Django. And then I'm just going to set a password here. And it's going to ask me if I want to add a firewall rule to allow my local computer to be able to connect to the database. So you can allow that if you want. I'll show you how to do the migration in a second. And it's important, I think, when we do that step that you can connect locally from your computer. I'm going to skip it for now and I'll show you how to do that through the portal. And then for the penultimate step, you need to pick which resource group you want to put this database server in. So pick the same one that you set your Django application into, which in my case was demo 2. And then lastly, pick which region you want to go to. This should be the same region that you deployed your web application to. You want to keep the communication between those two things as fast as possible. And I deployed into West US, so I'll pick that one. It's now going to go and actually provision the Postgres server for me. And it's going to keep me updated about all the steps. That probably takes about 5 minutes to complete. In the meantime, we can go back and look at our settings because we're going to need to make some changes before we redeploy into production. So in the project folder, there should be the file settings.py. When we looked at this before we deployed into production, we changed a couple of things, like we turned debug mode off, for example, and we also changed the allowed hosts. And we set this sort of secret key up the top as well. So there's something else that's kind of important next, which is the database configuration. So you'll see that here. And the default is to use the SQLite engine, which is this file that got created automatically called db.sqlite3. We're going to need to change this configuration to instead connect into Postgres. So we're going to basically remove this section altogether. It's really important to note that if you've put anything in the database at this point, like the locations, for example, or destinations, things like that, then if you just change this configuration, when you provision the new database, that data is not going to be migrated across. So next, if you go up to the Azure portal, and then you look for the Azure database for Postgres SQL, and pick the second option, Azure Database for Postgres Servers, then you should see the database server that you just provisioned. So ours was called Ants Ruddy Cloud DB. We can click on that, and it's going to give us some information that we need to tell Django so it knows where to connect to. The first thing I need to do, though, is go down to Connection Security, and I need to open up our database server so that both the production web app and also my computer can connect into it. So I'm going to click this button here, add client IP address. It knows that's my IP. And then I'm also going to tick this box, which says allow access to Azure services so that my Azure web app will be able to connect into the database. Once I've done that, I can do save. And then once that's finished, both my local machine and our web application will be able to connect to the new Postgres database server. So going back to overview, we'll need to keep that open whilst we configure our application in the background. If you go back into settings.py, if you click on that link there, it'll give you some examples of how to configure Postgres. So we can copy this configuration here and just use that as a template for us just to get started with, just to make things a bit easier. The name is the name of the database. So in this case, we can just call it Django. The user was the username that we specified when we provisioned the account. And if you go back into the portal, it'll remind you what that is. So we can copy that to the clipboard and then just paste it in here. The password. Now, I don't particularly want to write my password in plain text in here so that everybody can read it. So we're actually going to do something slightly different. We're going to load that from the environment variables. And I'll show you in a second how to set that in there. OS, I haven't imported that yet in this file. So I can click on quick fix and it'll import that at the top of the file for me. So os.getenv will get the environment variable for the password and set that as the password. Next, we have the host, which will be the server that we're connecting into. And again, if you go back into the portal, you'll see the server name here. We can copy that across and then paste it into our host environment. You might want to make this an environment variable as well, just in case maybe it changes or you want to modify things. We'll have different database servers, but for now, I'm just going to leave it like that. There's also one extra setting that's missing, which isn't in the example, and that is that Postgres on Azure sets SSL, which is an encryption mechanism, to be required by default. You can turn that off, but I don't recommend doing so because it is more secure to have it on. So what you'll need to do is add another section called options, which is a dictionary. The key is SSL mode, and the value you want is require. That will make sure that when it tries to connect, it will use SSL in the connection. So you set the database name as Django, but the Django database doesn't yet exist, and the migrate command for Django won't create that for us. Luckily, we can do it through the VS Code extension. So if you open up the Azure tab again, go to databases, find the database server that you provisioned. You might have to click refresh to see it there. Expand that and you'll see the Postgres database, which is the default one. Leave that well alone. It has mostly configuration settings for Postgres. But if you right click on the database instance and then do create database, we can then type Django and it will create a Django database for us. That means when we run the migration command, we don't need to worry about that database existing beforehand. So once you're using Postgres as the database server, there's one extra dependency that you need to add to both your virtual environment locally and the one on the web app. And that's something called PsychoPG, which is the Postgres client for Python. So if you open up the requirements.txt file and add psychopg2-binary as the requirement, you'll also want to install that locally because we're going to test this in a second. So pip install psychopg2-binary, and then it'll pull that down and install that for you locally as well. Once that's all configured, we can deploy the base database, so this is all the tables and the structure and stuff, by running the migrate command locally. And because we've allowed the firewall for our machine to connect into the database server, we can run that migrate command here before we deploy the application back up into the web application. So if you open up a terminal, we're going to need to set this environment variable first. So there's a couple of ways you can do this, but one, probably the easiest, is that you can do that on the command line For Mac and Linux, you would use export the name of the environment variable and then the value. For Windows, you would do set db password and then the value after that. So I'm going to do that locally. I'm on Mac, so I'm going to use the export command and do my password. Python manage.py migrate. It'll connect to our new database server. It'll provision all of the tables for us and all of the structure. So it'll tell us that it's running all the migrations, ready to go. And then once that migration is completed, we can then go ahead and push our application up onto app services. Before we do that, we need to make sure that environment variable with the password in it is going to exist on our application service instance. So again, go back to the Azure tab, go to app services and locate the app that you had deployed before. So mine was Ant Space Tours. Go to application settings, right click on that and do add new setting. That's going to be DB password as the name. And then the value will be whatever you configured as the password. And just hit enter and that will synchronize with the remote server automatically. And then once you're ready to go, we can click on deploy to web app. And it's going to warn us that it's going to overwrite what is there already. And the deployment's going to run. So we can keep an eye on that like we did before by just watching the output window. And then our website is up and running with the full database server. Now, there is one last thing we need to keep in mind, and that is if you go to the admin page, it's going to ask you to log in with the super user name and password. But because the super user record is in the database, then it's still going to be in that SQLite database that you created at the beginning of this project, and it's not going to exist on the Postgres database that you've created. So you will need to go back into your terminal and do python manage.py create super user and then provide the name, the username, your email address, and any password that you want to set for the super user account. And then once you've done that, when you go back, that should just let you log in there. Now, if you want to go ahead and add the cruises and the destinations and stuff back into the database, then you can do that through the admin portal. So congratulations, your web application is now running in production. You've got your database deployed, you've got database server running, and Django is all set up and ready to go.